Once again, the courses on the women's side of the Olympic Games came up for much criticism in the pre-Olympic competitions, but as we have seen earlier on this week in the training runs for the men's downhill, they're actually a lot more difficult than many had at first anticipated. So the women's super giant slalom starts off quite steep. Two very difficult jumps, including the Panorana jump and the Uma Dome jump and the Sun Terrace hairpin bend, three of the key areas which will decide the medals in today's super giant slalom competition, a 587 meter vertical drop with a maximum gradient of over 51%. Well, the atmosphere really is quite electric here in Hakuba, with all eyes on Germany's Katja Seizinger, very much the pre-race favourite. On the Women's World Cup Tour, they have had six supergiant slalom competitions, and out of those six events, Katja Seizinger has won four, dominating not only the women's overall World Cup Tour standings, but also dominating this discipline from the start of the season, a discipline that she has won the World Cup title in twice before. Coming back from injury for the United States of America, had that horrific crash a couple of weeks ago in Aura in the last downhill prior to these Winter Olympic Games. America's Picabo Street. She's never won in supergiant slalom before, but she said in a press release prior to today's competition, she's really desperate to do well in this event as part of her preparation to take the downhill title of the Olympic Games away from Germany's Katja Seizinger, very much her arch rival. She has won a bronze world championship medal in Super G, 109, just over 60 miles per hour through the early speed gun. That bronze medal in the world championships of Sierra Nevada, like Ingeborg Marken, Picabo Street getting bounced around on the hairpin. The Sun Terrace hairpin. Now a series of tight technical turns. Getting good pressure against the turning ski. Nice and high and early. This is good skiing from Street. Uses the downhill skills to good effect off these rollers, these jumps, throwing the skier into the air. Street, never better than 11th on the World Cup Tour, but the Olympic Games is a special temperament, a special psyche is required. And look at the margin! 1.14 seconds faster than Ingeborg Helen Marken. Picabo Street has had a flyer. Didn't look that impressive, particularly here in the Sun Terrace hairpin. But the lower section, Street finding good speed. Now Meissnitzer, always a threat in the speed events. Two Super G career victories to her name. The Austrian squad really coming on in the high speed competitions with their new coach Carl Freshner, formerly with the Swiss downhill squad. No better than sixth on the World Cup Tour, but ever consistent. She's been in the top 15 in five out of six Super Gs. A good low tuck position, an indication. Look how she's driving the hands forwards. Very aggressive top section from Meissnitzer. Big jump off the panorama. And is rewarded by far the fastest through the speed gun, heading up to 65 miles per hour. Need to stay high and early in the Sun Terrace hairpin turn. Meissnitzer, a fine giant slalom skier, a potential medalist for Austria in that event. And this is where those technical skills come into play. Now it's the downhill technique once again, gliding 500s. Picabo Street sees the first skier looking to threaten her time. A little wild off the jump for Meissnitzer. The police officer from Abtenau looking to deny Picabo Street the gold medal, and she's just missed it. 0.07 of a second down. Meissnitzer goes into silver medal position. Street will be happy to have got better of the better of the Austrian number one. There you can see how delighted she is.
She's got a star by her name.
Well, star or not, the star of the show is still Picabo Street as racer number six, the first of the German team, Regina Haeusl, and a 24-year-old, second in supergiant slalom, number five on the tour, and again a racer that has prepared meticulously for these Winter Games. Meissnitzer. Nice and aggressive on the top section. Setting up the turn high and early. Holding that aerodynamic tuck position. Just a little mistiming on the first jump. Loses a couple of kilometres per hour of speed to opening up too soon. Now the turning skills drawn upon. That's a very high line. Much, much higher than Picabo Street and Alexandra Meissnitzer. Street and the Austrian were happy to let the turn run out wide, but Haeusl opting to carve high. Halfway split, 0.26 of a second. Haeusl again in trouble off the jumps. Now the German is finding the turns and the gliding sections much to her liking in the air. She's in all kinds of trouble, but 0.26 is well within Heusel's capability coming into the finish. 1:18.02, Haeusl just misses out. A quarter of a second down on Picabo Street. The American has seen off the first of the big guns from the German team. Diann Roffe there working for American television just to the right of Picabo, the 1994 Winter Olympics Super-G gold medalist. Renate Goetschl, a racer that you can never write off. 1:18.02 still remains the target. The world combined champion. And in the last World Cup, Super-G, prior to today's event, was runner-up to Katja Seizinger, who skis next. Goetschl, 22-year-old from Obrach, a motor racing fanatic. Would quite like to take up motor racing herself. And having seen the way she skis, and it is incredibly fast, well, I'd not like to be behind the wheel with her. Twice a runner-up to Katja Seizinger. Look at the speed through the gun. Starting to get closer to 70 miles per hour now. Superb top section from Goetschl. Coaches often fear that Goetschl pushes that little bit too hard. Try and get her to relax and take it easy. Austria looking to take the gold away from the United States of America. Goetschl flies a little wild and ragged off the last roller. 200s is her advantage at the last split. Picabo Street watches on for the USA. Renate Goetschl tucks it in. It's gone. It's disappeared. A mistake off the final jump. Opening tall, catching wind. Goetschl throws away her medal chances. And Picabo Street sees off another challenger. The hot favourite, the Olympic downhill champion, Katja Seizinger. Four Super-G victories from six races this season. Also won the last downhill. Seizinger, stranger to the Olympic pressures. She was the bronze medalist in this discipline in 92. This her third Olympic Games. Very compact off the jump. It looks very clean so far. Again, faster than Picabo Street through the early speed gun. Some terrace hairpin bend. The roller's set to throw the racer wonderfully high. That is by far the highest line we've seen. Climbing the wall of the bank. .36, Katja Seizinger has work to do. The German pre-race favourite finds herself again struggling off the last jumps, a similar mistake to that of Renate Goetschl. Seizinger now has the finish within her sights, now tucks it in tight, 1:18.02. Seizinger's out of the medals. The big shock of the women's supergiant slalom, Katja Seizinger can only manage fifth position. Picabo Street is ecstatic. Street, Meissnitzer and Haeusl, the 1, 2 and 3. And Picabo Street starting to look better and better. Michaela Dorfmeister of Austria Dorfmeister's had two quite impressive top 10 results in Val d'Isère and Altamont. Quite an erratic skier. On her day, she's one of the world's best, but struggles to find the all-important consistency ingredient on the Women's World Cup Tour. Now, if she can show some of the early season form that she demonstrated back in December, she could be a threat to Picabo Street. But the form that she showed in the last two World Cups has really not been that good. That's a lovely clean jump off the panorama, staying in the tuck position, not opening up at all. And he's rewarded, 0.41. Just needs to find another couple of tenths. Nice and relaxed in the upper body. The skis absorbing every little undulation, every little roller. Another good series of turns from Dorfmeister. 0.26, she's found time. Just needs to find another tenth and she's in the medals. Michaela Dorfmeister looking very strong. Seems to have saved a little in reserve. Picabo Street's time could be in danger from racer number 18. Oh, 1/100th of a second. Dorfmeister misses gold by the narrowest of margins. That must be the luckiest escape of Picabo Street's career. Austria goes silver and bronze. Picabo Street holds on to gold.